Dr. Jennifer James is an urban cultural anthropologist who was a professor at the University of Washington Medical School prior to developing her public lectures and corporate seminars, which she presents worldwide. She is a specialist in the cultural elements of technological change and marketing intelligence. Her unique background in history, psychology, and anthropology makes her one of the most sought-after women speakers in the world. She works extensively with boards and high-level executive groups on strategic planning and international problem solving. Dr. James is a researcher, writer, and commentator. She has published 7 books, numerous academic articles, and wrote a newspaper column for the Seattle Times for 18 years. Her most recent book is Thinking in the Future Tense, and she is founder of the Committee for Children, a nonprofit organization that for 25 years has developed curriculums for the protection of children and the development of alternatives to violence. These curriculums are taught in every state and in 38 other countries.
So how can I be helpful? That's the only reason I speak anymore, is to use my energy in some kind of useful way. And in this case, I'm an outsider. This is definitely a culture. This is a lodge. This is a tribe. This is an anthropologist, of course, speaking, and I'm an outsider to this, which means you're going to get a different viewpoint. But I thought I better toss in who I am. I'm an urban cultural anthropologist. The urban part, I look at dense populations, although I did my field work in India and Southeast Asia, so I've also worked with tribal societies. The cultural part is that I deal with belief systems, the beliefs you have in your gut about the way things ought to be. And as you know, it takes an extraordinary amount of time, science, logic, or reason, for people to realize the world isn't flat. And we think that only applies to them, and we don't realize it applies to us as we speak right now. Anyone in this audience, if you can remember most things, you're not working very hard. If you find that you're forgetting, spelling and math and, who that person is that you just met that you forgot that you were doing a project with, you're normal. It means you're working at the cutting edge. And you are in overload. You'll be rescued by technology. That's why men are wearing earrings, because we're going to put this little computer in your ear and it will tell you everything. Mathematics, spelling, you'll still have to learn it all. Your cars will navigate. It'll take care of your schedule. Someone walks towards you in this room, you'll say, "Do I know them?" Yes, you do. And it will tell you what you promised them. So technology can bridge many, many gaps, but technology cannot bridge the mythological gap. But my other area of interest, which is perhaps more useful to you today, is my work in adaptive strategies. I've wanted to understand, why is common sense not common practice? Right? Doesn't it drive you crazy on a regular basis? I mean, how long it took medicine to wash its hands? It's a very interesting thing. Why does it take so long to commit to the obvious? The speed of change. Perhaps I should start there. One of the reasons that we have this malaise, that we have this anxiety, that you feel that you're bridging troubled waters, is because we have never in the history of humanity seen change of this magnitude. Anthropologists like me look at millions of years of history, and we've never seen anything like this. This is the deepest, the broadest, the most rapid change in history. The speed of change, you know why. It is a connection with the world. The minute you have communication links to China, some of us were raised when you got to China by digging a hole in your backyard. Do you remember those mythologies? When you have essentially the internet as a universe, with or without, its accuracy, you have a whole world that is linked up to a huge database. You go on safari, and you're in the middle of the Serengeti, and you're at a lodge that is basically a glorified tent, and there's a Maasai warrior who's been sent to entertain you, and he is, when he's not talking to you, he is the internet. He's never seen a regular telephone. He's never seen telephone wires. He's never seen electrical. Nothing plugs in. But he can use a battery-operated computer and an internet Wi-Fi to link to the universe. I mean, we have in Saudi Arabian deserts camel herders with Honda generators and satellite dishes on their camels watching CNN.